Today we're taking a look at a versatile, ugly, but potentially the most durable small power station on the market. This is the EcoFlow River 2 Pro. So what is up, guys? Welcome back to the lab. This right here is the big brother of the River 2, which is actually the, I think, the only unit EcoFlow's made a video on, just completely thrashing. They froze it, smashed it, melted it, threw it down a flight of stairs. All tests that we actually would really love to recreate, seeing that we only have one unit, and if it goes to shit, we have no way to fake the results. So if you guys get this video to 1,000 likes, we will head straight outside and start absolutely doing our best to demolish this and see if it lives up to those standards. EcoFlow actually makes some of the most popular larger power stations, and we've been hands-on with a lot of them, and they all perform really well, and this is actually our first time being hands-on with one of these smaller EcoFlow units. But regardless of how well the bigger stuff has performed in the past, you guys know that here at the lab our opinions cannot be bought, so we will leave some links down below if you want to check this thing out at any point during the video. Otherwise, we're going to jump into a super quick 2-minute teardown for everyone that's not already familiar with the EcoFlow River 2 Pro. First up, Tiny Baby absolutely destroyed this thing. It only weighs 17 pounds, so it passed the Tiny Baby lift test with flying colors, but we both agree that it actually feels a lot heavier than 17 pounds. I think just due to the handle placement. This is a 768 watt hour lithium iron phosphate battery. It has an 800 watt inverter with a surge capacity X boost of 1600 watts, which we will get into later. In terms of charging, you can charge this from a wall outlet in your house with 940 watts, which EcoFlow advertises gets it from 0 to 100 in 70 minutes, which does not math. Turns out it's just not as efficient as you would hope. At 768 watt hours of input, it should take 1 hour to charge a 768 watt hour unit. This was cruising just under 900 for the most part, and it still took just over an hour to fill it up, which is obviously still super fast. It's just a little disappointing. There's also a solar input on the back. It's a 220 watt input, so you can charge this thing from zero to full in about 3.5 hours. On the front, we have 4 120 volt house plugs. We have 3 USB-A's and 1 100 watt USB-C. So at least the USB-C is good and rated for laptops and stuff like that. We also have a 12 volt car socket and 2 barrel connectors. And in terms of screen, we're running with the same thing EcoFlow puts on basically all of their units. It's actually really nice to look at. It's simple, informative, and I don't have any complaints with it. In terms of design, this thing kind of looks like ET, just speeding super fast down the street. And like most EcoFlow products, this is included in their ecosystem in the app. So you can actually go in the app and change the charging speed and do a couple other things you don't have access to do directly from the unit. And in terms of price, this unit costs $599, but it's on a pretty permanent looking sale for $469, which puts this at a really competitive price. And jumping straight into our favorite features, although this thing does look kind of like ET, something we do like about it is the design. Everything is forward facing, and you can actually even charge this thing through the USB-C port on the front. That helps a lot for when you're trying to put this inside of a car. The flat surface lets you stack stuff on it. You can kind of jam it in the back of anything or anywhere, and you can still access all of the plugs and everything you need right here on the front. I also really like that there's 4 120 volt plugs on the front. A lot of these smaller units really limit how much access you actually have to plugs. Having access to more than just 2 plugs is always a huge bonus. And as always, the EcoFlow app, it lets you go in there and choose charging speeds and change settings and screen timeouts and things that you just can't do from the unit. And a lot of smaller units just don't connect to an app. So they're basically just, you get whatever you get right out of the box, and that's the way it is. So I love that EcoFlow still included their small units in their ecosystem of apps. And I think the last thing that's pretty cool about this unit is that it has what EcoFlow is calling X boost. And basically it's some trickery, but it allows the inverter to run at 1600 watts, which is its surge capacity, basically all the time. So it is an 800 watt inverter. And usually with a surge capacity, once you get past 800, it's not gonna last that long. But with this unit, there's actually a setting in the app that you can turn on, and it allows this to basically fool the device that's plugged into it into thinking that it's actually getting 1600 watts. So it will run a bigger device than just the 800 watts that it's actually rated for. Which floats us down the river into things that we just don't like. And the first thing is that that X boost is kind of a gimmick. It doesn't really give 1600 watts, just playing with voltage and stuff to pretend that you're getting 1600 watts. It won't work with everything. It isn't a legit thing.
So it even tells you right here in the app that there's gonna be voltage fluctuations, but what's weird is with X boost turned on, this little heater that we have is 750 watts on the first setting and 1500 watts on the second setting. But if you go ahead and turn this guy on, first setting, obviously it works perfectly fine. And you can see the output is a little more than 750, but nothing crazy, like 785. When you go ahead and flick this to what should be 1500, it just voltage cuts and turns off and stays at 800-ish. It's still running, but it's completely cut voltage to it. This is within the X-Boost 1600 watts, and it now it just shut off. As I was doing that, it just tripped. The whole thing just shut right off. So that's not ideal. It says overload.
So if you're looking at this thinking, hey, it's actually a 1600 watt inverter, it's not. It's an 800 watt inverter that if you wanna run very specific items, you can run them at 1600 watts. And what should be no surprise to you guys at this point is that I don't like that there is no light on this unit at all. More so, the EcoFlow doesn't have a single light on a single unit that they sell at all. Why? This is geared towards camping. This is called the River. And while that might seem like a small feature to someone who's just watching a bunch of YouTube videos trying to learn about power stations, I promise you, this first time you take one of these out into the world and you're trying to use it in the dark, you are gonna really, 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 really wish that you had a light on this thing. And the last two things that I just really don't like about this unit is the solar input isn't huge at 220 watts. There's not a lot to work with. And I also found during testing this thing that it has a hard time with the fan. Part of the testing we do is I just run the computers and stuff off this in the office for like a whole day. And there's a point where this wouldn't just come on and the fan would run, but the fan would kind of surge up and then come down and surge up and then come down within like a matter of seconds. It was just constantly going up and down. A unit like this, you're probably gonna be using it in close proximity to you if you're camping or taking it around like that. So you're gonna hear it. And it's a lot easier to drown out the sound of a constant fan than it is a fan that has no clue what it's doing. It's always jumping around and doing different things. At the end of the day, if you're watching this video, odds are you're trying to make a decision, and you know we can't leave you hanging without doing a quick comparison. The River 2 Pro stacks up against a ton of different things, but if you guys wanna compare apples to apples, there is really only one thing that actually competes with the River 2 Pro, and that is the brand new Anker C800X or Plus or whatever they call this thing right here. This is also a 768 watt hour battery, exactly the same as this. This has a 1200 watt inverter. This has an 800 watt inverter. And this unit is $449, or you can also pay $499 and you get it with the little party trick with the thing and the lights and the cool stuff. If you guys haven't already seen the video about this thing, go check it out. It's actually really cool. Now, the thing with this is this unit literally just came out like maybe 2 weeks ago. So obviously it's had all the improvements over the year or however long that this has been out, but this is the market options right now as of filming this video. And to be honest, this is kind of a crush unit. This one comes with the unibrow light that of course I absolutely love. It also has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plugs on the front, whereas this one has 4. It's got the IQ ports on the front, and this one just charges faster all around. It has a 1440 or something like that watt AC input. So when you plug it into the wall, supercharge on this thing right here. It also has a 300 watt solar input. So not crazy, but it is still higher. But at the end of the day, they're really, really similar units. And honestly, if you're brand loyal to either one of these, you can't go wrong. It's also worth noting that this unit has some sort of drop resistance testing thing that they say it qualifies for. So I'm actually really curious. Leave a comment and let me know if you guys want to see us beat the crap out of these units or if I'm just excited to break shit. But at the end of the day, you're looking at a River 2 Pro and you want to know, should you buy it? Honestly, now that there's a C800, I would say do your research and make a decision based on which one's gonna suit your needs best. But like I already said, if you're brand loyal or if you don't really care at all and you find a sweet deal on this, this is a really good unit. Absolutely would still recommend it. That is all we got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you guys in the next one. If you're still confused and you don't know what the heck power station you should buy, we actually made a little quiz. It's super quick to do. There's a link in the description. Otherwise, I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.